In many schools, bring your cell phone to class and you're bound to get in trouble. Forget your textbook and it could be a trip to the principal's office. But times are changing in classrooms across the country. Today, we look at how new technology is changing how students learn, and we begin in Durant, Oklahoma.
In the halls of Durant High School, traditional textbooks are hard to find, replaced by laptops in the classroom.
It has really changed our classrooms. Lately, we've been watching a lot of videos on our subject, which really helps with visual learning. Other than books, the books you read it sometimes are kind of boring, they're outdated. This is up-to-date stuff we're just learning about.
Jason Simeroth is the superintendent of Durant Schools and says it's all about keeping education on the leading edge.
The halls are lined with these LCD screens so that we can we can run our own programming, we can run local programming, keeps kids up to date.
Thanks to the work of Durant High School's media team.
Okay. 3, 2.
Thanks, Katie. Congratulations to the golf.
Inside this classroom, students run their own TV studio. Standing in front of a green screen, the young people present everything from interviews to upcoming events and public announcements, all broadcast over a closed circuit system available school-wide.
In the classrooms, they can do virtual field trips, a variety of things like that. What we're desiring to do is to make it a learning tool so that kids leave here prepared for college or work. Because when you leave here, you have a computer on your desk 8 hours a day, and we want them to be able to go and be part of that environment.
Inside this new school, it's not just the technology that sets it apart. It's how they use the technology.
We'll go into our media center.
Now, back in my day, we would have called this a library.
Right, and even though it still has some traditional things like textbooks, the media center is more evolved than it was when we were in school. All of our textbooks are online, too. We have, or not online, but are electronic.
Students use what are called netbooks for their coursework, computers that already have all of their textbooks downloaded on them, making everything easy to access at the touch of a button.
But what we've done is we've taken it a step further with access to all kinds of media, whether it's video, e-books, production, the ability to come in here and put together publications of the kids on their own, on the electronic side of it.
Something Simeroth believes not only as a school administrator, but also a parent.
Thanks for
Meet Summer Simeroth, a sophomore who's given up on books.
I really like the computers better because it's almost more interesting and the kids get to interact more, and it has a lot of cool settings on it that you can use when you're online books, like highlighting and adding notes and stuff. When you interact more, it almost seems like you're getting more of the learning experience.
A learning experience for both students and teachers.
The room the other day, Alex, everybody's beginning to understand that the more technology, whatever level you are, whether you're a high school student or an adult these days, that you're going to have to keep up because everything's gone to computers and technology. But yesterday, we have the best. You know, we have the best computers that are available. We have the best software that's available. So our kids are probably a little bit ahead of the game.
We really emphasize that the kids do the work in school. The teachers do their work in their plan time, preparing. And they do a lot of work on their own after school even. And when they get to class, it's, okay, here's what we're talking about today. Here's the instructions that we're going to get. And now they get busy, and then it's just like one of the classrooms you walked into. We see teachers going to individual kids and working with them directly. So it is a guide on the side type of platform now, more than the stand up and lecture and let me tell you everything you're supposed to know, write it down and memorize it. Because that's not authentic learning, and our teachers are well-versed in really making it relevant to students today and what they're going to do in the future.
LuAnn Latona has been a teacher at Durant for 31 years.
The sky's the limit, because there's some new things, whether it's coming through the internet or, you know, just what's coming through the pipes of news media. And can we recreate that? Yes, we can.
You make it darker.
Yeah, I probably should, so it pops. A community. We take care of each other. We support each other. We learn together. We go through challenges together, and we succeed together. We are an awesome school.
Now, while you can find virtually all types of technology here in this school, what you're not going to find in Durant High School is something that typically is on the wall, lockers.
Students are not issued textbooks. They don't have a need to have a locker to store textbooks in. With the lack of lockers, we have cut down on tardy students. They're not tardy for class. They're not congregating in the hallway. A lot of issues are solved by not having lockers. We don't have the a lot of the tension between students, if they're, you know, the pushing and the shoving, trying to get to my locker because someone else is standing in front of it. Solved a lot of issues.
Cheryl Condit is the high school principal and truly believes in the changes taking place here.
Well, our philosophy here at Durant is that we want to prepare students for whatever they want to do after high school.
Oh, that's a different color red.
What they learn is still the same. Okay, they're still learning math skills, language arts skills, communication skills, social skills within the, you know, the building and their peers and everything. All of that is still very, very the same and common, but it's the way that they're learning it, and we have to keep up with the students because they learn with technology. They're so much quicker with it than we are, so a lot of times we're learning to keep up with them.
Changing classrooms for our changing times.
When we return, we'll meet an educator who says it's not just our classrooms experiencing a technology revolution. We'll examine global competition in the digital age.